Hello, Periscope. How y'all doing? I hope y'all having a great Wednesday. I see several of you are coming in. Tamara, Draped in Praise. All right. Tierica, how are you? Glad you all are chiming in. Today is Wednesday. It's hump day. I wanted to stop in just to encourage you all, even to share with you all, kind of like my day, what's going on. Hello, Mendez, Menderos 20. All right, glad you all joined us. I hope y'all having a wonderful day. I'm jamming in the background, cleaning my little house. Good afternoon. Hey, Debbie. All right, good to see you, Debbie. Miss Nelly, number one joined. All right, it's game time, y'all. I hope y'all ready. 2016, it's game time. All right, look, let's see. Al Frazier, 17 joined. Okay. Draped in Praise. Thank you, Debbie, for sharing. I'm going to ask you guys to share this. I think several people are going to be encouraged because I'm on assignment in 2016. I'm telling you, I'm going to do all that God has called me to do, and I'm going to help many of you do all that God has called you to do. I'm going to be y'all life coach. I'm going to be y'all motivator. All right, and then give me the hearts. Y'all, look at the hearts, 2016. Y'all see how it's coming up? 2016 is popping up everywhere. All right. So anyway, let me turn my camera around, but I just want y'all to hear my music. This is Jay Moss. He's jamming, saying, I'm going to do it. And that's what we got to say. We're going to do it. So let me turn my camera around so y'all can see me. Hello. How y'all doing today? Glad y'all having a good day, Bruce Davis. Hey, 514. Hey, Bruce. That's my deke. All right, let me turn my little music down. I wanted y'all to hear that because you know what? All today, I was cleaning my little house up. Hey, D, how you do? I was cleaning my little house off of this little music being all pumped up, telling y'all it's game time. I ain't playing with the devil this year. Y'all gotta let the devil know, man, I'ma do it this year. But anyway, let me just call my little music off. How y'all doing today? I wanted to chime in to say hello to everybody. And thank you all for joining. I know some of you are probably at lunch, or even on your lunch break. I'm off today. We're preparing for our worship service on tomorrow, which is our New Year's Eve service. It's going to be awesome, awesome, awesome. And so, like I stated, hey, yes, it's game time. That's right, it's game time. I'm telling you, because some of us are still sitting on the bench. Some of y'all warm in the bench. The bench is hot because you're sitting on the bench. It's time for you to get all off the bench and into the game. We're not playing with the enemy this year. We're not playing when it comes to our dreams and our passions. When we look back on 2015, some of y'all are a little disappointed because, you know what, you sat on that bench a little bit too long. You watch other people huddle, but you didn't get in the huddle. So that's what my scope is going to be about today. It's game time. Get off the bench. Bench warmers, this season is over. Bench sitters, the season is over. Okay, so we're not sitting on no benches this year. 2016, we're getting off the bench and we're going to get in a huddle. And thank you all for coming on that are joining. We're talking about it's game time. 2016 is game time. We don't have time to be playing. We have to get serious about what it is that we've been assigned to do and stop being afraid and stop being scared. So I want to talk to you about that. For those of you that are new to my scope, huddle up. That's right, huddle up. Debbie, I'm so proud of you, y'all. This is one of my clients. She is releasing her book in January. I'm so excited. It's entitled The Woman at the Well, From Guilt to Grace. I'm so proud of her. She has taken what was on the inside of her and she's allowed us to help her birth it. For many of you that don't know me, I'm Geronda B. I am a leadership and business consultant. This year, as I begin to fine tune what it is that God has called me to do, this is the acronym God gave me, LEAP. L-E-A-P. LEAP. That's my assignment for the rest of my life. I finally understand. Praise God for you. Thank God for you, Debbie. I finally understand what it is I've been assigned to do. LEAP. I'm focusing on encouraging and empowering leaders. That's my assignment. I have a passion for leaders. I have a passion to see them grow. I have a passion to see them develop. I'm on assignment for leaders. I'm on assignment for potential leaders as well. Those of you that have a desire to lead, but maybe you're afraid. Some of y'all may not be in the first chair. You might be in the second or the third chair. I want to encourage you to lead. For those of you who are authors, authors, potential authors, I'm on assignment for you. It's game time. Those books, those things that God has placed on the inside of you, your life story, your testimony, on it. It got to get out. So I'm here to help you. For those of you, like I say, L-E-A, I forgot my E, right? My E is entrepreneurs. Those that are business owners, potential business owners. Maybe you want to own your own business, don't know where to begin. Then I want to help you. And I want, so like I say, the L-E-A-P, I'm on assignment for leaders, entrepreneurs, authors, but then P. Y'all know I call myself the principle girl. I'm going to always live by the principles of God's word. I'm going to share with you life principles. I'm going to share with you biblical and spiritual principles that's going to help you go to the next level. Y'all, I've finally fine-tuned my assignment. And that's what you have to do. You can't be effective in the game if you haven't fine-tuned what's your life vision. What is it that God has called you to do and put you on assignment to do? Because most of the time, thank you for all of you that are joining. If for those of you, invite friends to join this scope. I'm telling you, it's going to empower them and encourage them. It's game time. For those of you, you got to fine tune your life. You got to find out what has God called you to do. You know what? When you find out what God has called you to do, guess what? You won't compare. Hi, Kendra. You won't compare. You won't compete. Nor will you complain. See, that many of us are sitting on the bench and we're warm in the bench. And we won't get in a huddle because we're so busy talking about other people, what they're doing, the moves they're making. God said, get in a huddle and stop all that foolishness. Get in a huddle. And then when you get in a huddle, then you can do some great things for the kingdom of God. So I was just like sitting down and really just understanding my assignment. Like I stated, God told me this is my acronym for the year 2016. He told me, he said, it's game time, number one. And then he said, your assignment is for leaders. Potential leaders. Your assignment is for entrepreneurs, potential entrepreneurs. Your assignment is for authors, potential authors. And your assignment is to make people understand the significance of being principled people, living by the principles of God's word. So God said, that's what you to do, to leap into 2016 on assignment. And that's what I'm saying. I'm a coach, man. I'm not going to sit back and let my sisters and my brothers rot. I'm not going to sit back and let your dreams die. I'm not going to sit back and let you think that you don't have what it takes. We're going to help you get what you need in order for you to succeed. So I'm excited about 2016. Y'all, I have my little journal. I've been journaling all day. I got my little outline, what it is I'm going to do. Come on, coach. Yeah. God says it's time. It's time for us. We got some things that we have to do. So I want you, for those of you that are leaders on this scope, I'm after you. I ain't letting you sit on the sideline. I ain't gonna let you keep operating with the attitude you have, the slowfulness you have. Those of you that are authors, I'm after you. Yes. Just like I helped Debbie birth her book, I'm going to help you birth your books. I'm going to show you how to become your own self-publisher. I self-published my own book. Y'all, I did it. And you can too. And I want to help you do that. So I'm after authors. I'm after entrepreneurs. I'm after people who want to start their own business. I want to help you. I want to help you put systems in place that's going to help you succeed. But most of all, I'm a principal girl. That's what I told you. I'm a principal girl. So today, I said all that to say, I really won't even go there, y'all. I really didn't want to even go there. But I said all of that to say to you that God is saying it's time for you to get in the game. Stop watching people make some major moves and you've seen the results. They're successful. Why? Because they're making a move. They're getting off of the bench and they're getting in the game. And God says, you got to get in a huddle. And so this is what I wanted to share with you all today. The scripture that I'm standing on for 2016. Every time I find myself just sitting there and allowing my dream or my passion or what it is that God has told me to do, whatever he told me to do, anytime I get in a rut, I have to be reminded of Deuteronomy. Y'all know I'm a principal girl. I'm going to give you the word. So Deuteronomy chapter 2 and verse 3. This is what it says. How long are you going to continue to skirt this mountain, going in circles, round and round? How long are you going to continue to skirt this mountain? He says what? Go northward. That's what it says. It's right there in Deuteronomy chapter 2. It's like, what? The word is telling us it's time for you to shift. It's time for you to reposition yourself. It's time for you to get off of that bench and get up and get moving. So what God is saying, how long are you going to stay in the same condition? You know, some of us, we're echoing, man, 2016 going to be my year. Oh, really? So when you look at December 31st in 2016, what will you be able to say? What did you accomplish?
You know, so that's why I even put it on my Facebook page. What's one word that could describe your 2015? And several people said mine was sad. And yes, we're going to go through valleys. We're going to go through mountaintop experience. Some people said failure because you know what they realized? Man, I started off good, but I ended up, man, I didn't do all I said I was going to do. So there's some things you got to put in place in order for you to win this game. And I'm going to help you put those things in place. And this is what God told me. This acronym, STOP. S-T-O-P. STOP. This is what the acronym is for. This is what God gave it to me. He said, number one, your S is sitting on the bench too long. Y'all, we can't be sitting on the bench. Man, you letting time pass you by. You are sitting on the bench. And you're allowing the enemy to keep you on the bench and you're not fulfilling purpose. So he said, some of you are sitting on some spiritual benches and you've been on them too long. How long are you going to stay on this bench? He said, so stop. Stop sitting on the bench. He said, go back to school. If you have to go back to school to get the degree you need, go back. If you need a coach, man, some of y'all are trying to tread this journey alone and you need to attach yourself to the right people to help you reach your purpose. You can't do it by yourself. You need help. You need a coach. You need a mentor. You need a spiritual leader. You need a pastor. You need people. So you need to stop. You need to stop sitting on the bench. And how do you stop sitting on the bench? Decide. Make a decision. Go back to school. Get you a coach or a trainer. If you're going to lose the weight, get off the bench and start walking. You don't have to pay for a gym. You can walk. Like my dad told me, he said, baby, I'll never pay for a gym. He said, all you got to do is look around your house and that's a workout. Some of y'all can start cleaning your ceiling fans. Your ceiling fan could become your workout. When you start reaching and cleaning and wiping and sweeping, that's a workout. So you can start there. So stop sitting on the bench. The other thing is your T. He say, taking time for granted. Ooh wee, that's a big one because we procrastinate and we take time for granted as if tomorrow is promised, as if next week is promised. No, you got to take advantage of today. If God has given you a vision for a business, don't wait till next week to write the plan. Don't wait till next week to get the marketing strategy in place. Time waits for no one. So you have to recognize the significance of wasting time, taking time for granted. Stop taking time for granted with your family. Stop thinking that they're going to be there forever. Love them now. Care for them now. Hug them now. Say you love them now. Spend quality time with them now. God says it's time for us to stop. It's time for you to stop taking time for granted. So that's your T. Guess what your O is? This is a big one. Overcome the fears. No, for real. That's how God gave me. Overcome them fears for real. Overcome the fear of loving again. Overcome the fear of, procrastination, failure. Because some of us, we don't want to get in the game because we're afraid. We're afraid that we won't make it. We're afraid that we won't succeed. No, you have to overcome your fears for real. You can't, your insecurities. If you're not confident in yourself, overcome that. How are we going to deal with your insecurity? You can't be in my huddle and you insecure. That's going to weigh me down. So you got to deal with your insecurities. Deal with what it is that you're struggling with. Deal with it now. So overcome your fears. And then y'all, the last one, this is how God gave it to me. He said, pick your partners, your people, your peeps carefully. You got to pick your people carefully. If you're going to huddle, you can't be in a huddle with the wrong people. You got to put the right people on the right bus. You got to ask God to send the right people in your life. No, that's serious business. Because many of us, we get a game plan. We ready for action. But then it is when we're ready for the action to take place, the people around us don't have no motivation. The people around us, they don't have a passion. The people around us are weighing us down. So God's saying it's time to stop. You have to pick your people, your partners carefully. If you're going to start a business, if you need a business partner, don't pick nobody who doesn't have a drive, an initiative, because that's going to weigh you down and slow you down. And guess what? You're going to lose the game. You're going to lose it. So you have to understand that God says it's game time. 2016 is going to be a major year for us. No, not just for you, but for the people connected to you. For many of us, we're going to really establish legacy this year. Meaning we're going to put some things in place that's going to cause our children, our family, generations to come to prosper in a miraculous way. And so we have to understand we are part of that. We are part of that. 2016 is major. It's a major, major year. We don't know all that's entailed. Because there are going to be some valleys and there's going to be some mountains. God's saying, I don't want y'all to think that it's always going to be good. But I want you to be ready. Because you know what I realized? When people get ready to play those football games, I don't know much about football. And many of y'all know that. I don't know much about football. But one thing I can say, even in their injuries, they still are committed to the game. Some of them are out there injured. And they still committed to the game, committed to winning. Heart you gotta have. That even when you are wounded, a warrior on the battlefield wounded, you ain't gonna just throw up your hands and quit. You can just walk away from your family, leave your job. No, you're gonna make it up in your mind, I'm on this team and we gonna win. That's what you gotta say. I want you to say that to yourself. I'm on this team. Whatever team that is, I'm in this family, I'm on this job, I'm in this ministry, I'm attached to this pastor, this is my leader, I'm on it and I'm in it to win it. That's how you gotta say it. What I'm talking about today is it's game time. In 2016, no playing around, get off the bench. Don't be no bench warmer, don't be no bench sitter, but get up and start making some moves. But these moves are not being made just for you. The moves are being made to establish history, to establish a legacy for generations to come. We see all that's happening in the world, and we just seen it. God's saying, no, I need to position you strategically. That's why I said in the very beginning, for those of you who are just joining my scope, I said it earlier. I said, I need you all to find out your purpose. Because when you find out your purpose, man, that's going to shape your reality. What that's going to do is that's going to really provoke you to get up and get moving. Because you know what your assignment is. So you don't have to compete with people. You don't have to complain about what others are doing. You don't have time to be looking at other people. You don't have to compare yourself because you realize you're unique and that God has uniquely gifted you. And not only gifted you, but assigned you to a particular place, person, and people. So you have to understand that. Now your life is filled with joy, y'all. I heard them clearly. And I'm going to echo it, and I'm going to continue to echo it. It's game time. It's game time. It's game time. And so 2016, you have now and tomorrow. Fine-tune your life right now. I hope you started already. I really do. But if you haven't, sit down today and fine-tune your life and say, Lord, in 2016, what's my assignment? In 2016, God, what's my assignment? Because it's game time for me. It's just like, y'all know when it's game time, that's what I tell many of our ministers, it's like, it's one thing to sit on the sideline and talk about what you're going to do, but it's not until you get out there, that's when it really go down. That's when the pressure really is on. And so it doesn't matter if you say, oh, I got this. Well, when you get the microphone, what happened? Ooh-wee. When you have all these thousands of people looking at you, are you really ready? Well, God is saying you've been sitting on that sideline too long. How long? Deuteronomy 2 and 3. How long are you going to continue to skirt this mountain? God says, I need you to position yourself. And then when you position yourself, he says, I need you to do something different. Don't do the same thing because that's stupidity. That's ignorance. That's doing the same thing, expecting results. If you keep doing the same thing over and over again, you really think you're going to get a different result, really. God says, come on, I need you to reposition yourself. I need you to do something different. I need you to change the way you've been thinking. And I need you to reposition yourself because it's game time. We all trying to win, y'all. Because the devil, you know what? One thing about the devil, he's on his job 24/7. The enemy, the spirits, evil, wickedness, never takes a break. They're always on their job 24/7. Never take sick leave. Always on their job. So we gotta always be on our job. So that's what I wanted to do today to encourage you guys because I'm ready. I'm ready. Because God said, you know what? He said, I need you to huddle. And that's what these periscopes are. When people have periscopes, I hope they're on assignment and they're not just blabbing. They're not just talking, but I pray that they're on assignment. It's a huddle. It's like us coming together saying, okay, this is the game plan. Let me give you the tools you need to succeed. Let me show you how to make this happen. Let me show you how to make this work. Because you know what? One thing about huddles, huddles will give you a plan. Huddles will empower you and others. Let me tell you something else about huddles. A huddle, as I stated, can cause you to win. So we need to have huddles. So get in your family. And I'm telling you, it's not just for your business. This is not just for your ministry. Get huddle with your family. Say, baby, we need to get a game plan on how we're going to win. Okay? We need to get a game plan on how we are going to win. Then when you get on your job with your leadership, come on, you got to ask them some serious questions. Are you in the game? No, really. Are you really in the game? It's game time. I need you engaged. Man, I need you to take your place. Because when you're not in your place, then that can cause us to lose. You need to get with your team. Huddle. Huddle and say, what do we need to do to win? What do we need to do to conquer? What do we need to do to overcome? You need to do that in the workplace. Like I said, look at all the areas in your life. Every area of your life, you need to huddle. You need to huddle. And that huddle is going to bring forth results this year. And so I thank God because, like I stated, y'all, God has given me full understanding of my assignment, and I'm ready for it. And I say, Lord, just let me keep the momentum and be consistent in what it is you're sharing with me. Don't let this just be, you know how we do like New Year's resolution. Oh, I'm going to do this. Then by the third month, you exhausted. No, we're gonna pace ourselves. And then most of all, we're going to have prayer as a priority in our lives. And then that's going to help us to win the game. So I just wanted to stop in to encourage you all. There are going to be so many opportunities, like I said, for us to huddle together, to come together and to really encourage each other. Like I said, my acronym this year and the rest of my life assignment is LEAP. L-E-A-P. I want to be known for that. LEAP. I want to be known for empowering leaders and potential leaders. I want to be known for encouraging authors and potential authors. Entrepreneurs. Y'all know I keep spelling that. I don't know why I have that A before the E. You know how that's what your teacher's got to tell you. I probably need to go back to my English class, huh? But L-E-A-P, y'all. L-E-A-P. So leaders. I'm on my assignment for leaders. Entrepreneurs. Those that are business owners. A is for authors. I'm on my assignment for authors. So if you're a potential author, stay connected with us. I'm going to even be giving shout outs to those who are authors. We're going to talk about your book. And I'm going to show you ways that we're going to do that. We're going to actually go through Blab. Actually, I'm going to be on Blab. Friday. I'm going to do a little test run. So if you are an author, inbox me or some kind of way, email me at Geronda B on Twitter or something like that, because I want you to be a part of the Blab. Blab is going to be something new for me. So guess what? We're going to be trying it out together. But this is going to be a way for us to talk about what inspired you to write the book. What inspired you to put this in paper and print form, you know, and how you got started and where you want to see this book go, what target audiences. We're going to really have some good conversations. So like I said, we're going to do that through Blab. So I'm on assignment for authors, but then most of all, I'm on assignment for principal people, people who want to get some spiritual principles to live a godly, successful life. You can't do it without God. The book that I wrote is Me Moments with the Master. I thank God for the opportunity for him to allow me to write that book. But that was that. I have many more books. But that number one book, Me Moments with the Master, that book is about prayer. It's helping you to establish a prayer life. That's significant. That's the most important thing. Before we start doing anything else, you got to have a prayer life. Because you know what? The more successful you become, the more blessed you become, the weightier the responsibility. See, we want more. But do you want more responsibility? So the more you become successful, you got to increase your prayer life, because the weight of it will destroy you. And that's why we see a lot of suicides and people who are celebrities and they wind up, Lord, you know, killing themselves or can't deal with the weight. Why? Their prayer life. Because the enemy, he knows the higher you go, the more attacks you receive. So we have to make sure that our prayer lives are in order. So the book that I wrote, Me Moments with the Master, a 31-day professional and inspirational devotion, that's my first book. And I thank God because, that, like I stated, that is priority. And that's why he told me to release that book first. So I wanted to encourage you also. We're going to have some great talks on Blabs, y'all. Get ready for Blab. If y'all see my name pop up, that's because I'm testing my Blab. And we're going to have a Blab. And that Blab is going to be called the Boss Books Boutique Blab Business Mixer. I know that's a lot of stuff, but we're going to be focusing on the CEOs, the professionals. So it's going to be called the Boss, the Books, and Boutique, the Biz Mixer on Blab. So we're going to be talking about that. So anyway, I hope y'all are blessed today. I wanted to come in to encourage you today to let you know that you're going to win. Why? Because we on number one, we're on the best team ever, Team Jesus, and we know we're going to win. So I wanted to encourage you all today. For those of you that are just joining, please go back. Please go back and look at the scope. All I wanted to do was to encourage you. All I wanted to do was to inspire you to get off the bench and to get in the game and for you to make sure that you are huddling, because winners huddle. Winners huddle. So let's stay connected. I know many of you have to go back to work. Like I stated, one more day before 2016 kicks off. And so I am excited about what God is going to do, because it's going to be great. So I'm off, you guys. As I always say, be you, be excellent, be unique. Because guess what? Nobody could beat you being you, because you are unique. Okay, you guys, thank you all for joining. I hope you all were blessed. And I want you to share the scope with someone, which many of you have already done. Happy New Year's to you too, Debbie. I love you so much and I appreciate you. Like I stated, great things are going to manifest for you. And I'm excited about your new book. And I know God is going to kiss that book with his favor. And so actually, let me do this, because hopefully I'll be back on the scope later tonight or possibly tomorrow morning. But I do want to cover you all in prayer. Thank you all for joining. Please go back and look at the replay. I know the principles that we shared is going to get you ready for 2016. And then I want you to share with other people. And I want you to stay connected to us, because I'm on assignment for leaders. I'm on assignment for entrepreneurs. I'm on assignment for authors. And I'm on assignment for principal people. Those individuals that want to go to the next level, I'm on assignment for you. And so I'm coming for you. Hi, you're from New Orleans. Who are you? Tell me your name. Like I said, let's stay connected. I'll be having some seminars on how to birth the book in you. That's going to be good. How to birth the book in you. Y'all better be ready. Hi, Harold. Bless you. We'll be coming to New Orleans. I'm a New Orleans girl, 504 girl. So we're going to be having workshops, like I said, to deal with leaders. I lead leadership seminars. We're going to, like I said, have also some seminars as well for Blessing Back. Okay, blessings back. Okay, thank you. I need all the blessings and the prayers. So you all, like I stated, thank you all. If you were blessed by what we were saying, if you heard what we were saying, I want you to type the acronym STOP. 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 2016, STOP. STOP. Okay, and that meant, and let me just say, I know y'all gonna go back and look at the replay, but as I stated, that means stop sitting on the bench and then don't take time for granted. Don't take time for granted. Then overcome your fears. And then the other one was pick your partners and your peeps, your people, carefully. So that's what we're going to do. If you're going to win the game, you got to do it. STOP, STOP, STOP. All right, you guys, I'm gone because I have a lot I have to do today. We're in preparation. It's game time. We're in preparation for our New Year's service at Beacon Light of Hammond. It's going to be off the chain. I'm so excited about our guests that are going to be there. It's going to be a blessing. Amen. That's good. Yes, yes. And if you just came on, though, I want you to go back to the replay, because I tell you why, how it is that God has birthed that on the inside of us. And so I'm going to keep on, you know, like I said, doing all that God has called us to do. So thank you for joining. So thank you all for the hearts. Give me some hearts. I love it. I love it. I love it. Y'all see the hearts? Say 2016. That's it. It's for real. 2016 is for real. It's going down in 2016. Y'all better be ready. I'm telling you, you better be ready. And if you're not ready, you're going to get aggravated with me, because I'm going to push you off that bench. And as I stated in my one of my hashtags, you ain't no rookie. Okay? Your rookie season is over. No more rookies. No more rookies. No more rookies. We have champions. We have people that wants to win. So we're going to win. We're going to win in our families. We're going to win in our finances. We're going to win in our faith. We're going to win, win, win. All we do is win, win, win. Y'all know how that move, that song go, right? All we do is win, win, win. All right, you guys, I'm gone. I hope y'all had a blessed day. So like I stated, I want you all to just stay connected with us. If you are an author, a potential author, I have a book in you. I want to know who you are. Please, I want you to inbox me, email me, somehow get in touch with us. Let me share with you how you can do that. All you have to do so you can get on our mailing list is you can text the letter U, R, U, unique. So the letter U, the letter R, the letter U, N-I-Q-U-E, to the number 2828. I had to think about that because I hadn't done that in a long, long time. So U, R, U, N-I-Q-U-E to the number 22828. And then you'll be on our mailing list. And then I'll send you information about all the things that we're going to be doing to help assist you in going to the next level. Okay? So I'm going, you guys. You all have a blessed day. And I'm not going to say Happy New Year because guess what? I'm coming back before the new year. I will be back. All right. You all have a wonderful day. I love you all. Bye.